Hi, I'm Tana Newberry.
Hi, I'm Andrea Rojas.
I am a psychic crystal and card reader.
And I read the tarot. We are both psychic development teachers.
Yes, we are. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Andrea.
So I've been doing tarot and oracle cards now for 16 years. And I have my own business right now where I'm looking to commit full time to reading people's cards.
Fantastic. And I have been a reader and teacher, psychic development for about 13 years, and I do that full time. And we are both super, super excited to be here to teach you our very own top 12 tips for developing your psychic readings, making them more accurate and more resonating. So, Andrea, would you like to take it away with tip number one?
Sure. I like to set intention with prayer and protection when I begin. I like to call upon the angels to please bless and protect this space and seal the reading in love and light with blessings in all ways possible. So I think that really helps me get into the right zone, as well as using some aromatherapy and votive candles and prayer candles to kind of help highlight, you know, the reason that we're there.
Perfect. And my tip number two is to suspend disbelief. It's very, very important, in my opinion, when you go into doing a reading that you stop trying to figure it out. You stop trying to figure out, you know, if you're going to do a good job or what is it going to mean? Is this person going to be, open and willing to receive? You know, we think all around, you know, and our brain just goes, So if we can just suspend disbelief for a minute and say, you know what? I'm going to get into the space. I'm going to stop thinking if it's going to be real or not, or good or not, or whatever. We just immerse ourselves, kind of like playing a game when we're a child. We stop trying to figure out what it means and we just hop right in and get into our role play or get into our space, and we just kind of go with it as if we know how to do it, or it doesn't even matter if we know how to do it. And that's my tip number two. Andrea, take it away with tip number three.
Sure. I believe it's important to also ground and connect. So I will usually try to do a grounding exercise to connect my primary aura body to the earth vibration. And then I also like to connect with my higher self vibration. And so that way I'm kind of working as a happy medium between the two.
Tip number four is real is not the opposite of the imagination. So in my psychic development classes, which I do quite often, I very, very, very much stress the fact that we don't have to look at things as real being the opposite of the imagination. Half the time we do readings, we're thinking, oh my gosh, did I make that up, or is that a real psychic hit? And my advice would be to stop again trying to figure it out. Instead, just roll with it. Now, we have this space in our brain that I kind of refer to as a slate. It's an empty space where if we said, hey, picture a green apple, the green apple kind of goes into this little space in our mind. Now, it's going to be there in that space in your mind, whether you're seeing it clairvoyantly or whether you're making it up from your imagination. But the thing is if you sit down to do a reading, you've opened up the space, you've set an intention to do a reading, you've got your client in front of you, you've called in your angels to help you, or whoever it is, if you're doing mediumship, maybe it's a family member's coming in, you gotta realize that your imagination is not the opposite of what's real. Instead, it is the most primary key to helping you unlock psychic information. As your creative side, your imaginative side allows you the boundless sort of opportunity that you need to gain the information that is not so obvious to your mental mind. So it is there that we are not limited by our own beliefs or limited by our own impressions, but we start to receive impressions from outside of us, which is the basis typically of psychic readings. So remember, real is not the opposite of the imagination. Andrea, take it away with tip number five.
Sure. During this time, as you're gathering information and kind of figuring out what you're sensing, it's important to pay attention to every sign, because they might end up leading into a thought that will serve as a motivator for your client, or something inspirational. So if you're looking at a deck of tarot cards and it's time for you to pay attention to the signs that are coming through, I would look at the symbols that first pop up on these cards and kind of try to connect a story as they evolve. So where we're going to find these signs, you know, you look at your tarot cards for the symbols, colors, numbers that pop out at you first and kind of take a note of that, as well as any sort of sensation, like is your gut tightening, is your heart accelerating, or any other thing that would be an indicator as to the direction that your tarot reading is going to go in.
Fantastic. And tip number six is I like to believe that everyone should ask in all four ways. Now, what I'm talking about here is clairvoyance, clairaudience, clairsentience, and claircognizance. Now, these four ways are respectively clairseeing, clear hearing, clear feeling, and clear knowing. So sometimes people have certain gifts more turned on or more naturally inclined to be able to be listened to from their perspective of giving a psychic reading. If you are hearing something and you're seeing something, don't forget to reach out and ask, what am I feeling? What do I just know about the situation? And on the other hand, if you are knowing something and you're feeling something, take a moment and stop and look in your mind in that imaginative place, right? That slate in your mind and say, what am I seeing? A lot of people forget to take a moment to listen. Am I hearing any words? Am I hearing any sentences that are popping up? This is something that is very commonly overlooked. Sometimes we just go for what's in front of us and we say it and we forget to reach out to the other, you know, one channel, two channels, sometimes three channels that were not apparent in the first glance. So please pay attention to the every sign, like Andrea said in tip five, and take it a step further. Ask in all four ways, tip number six. And now, Andrea, please share tip number seven.
Now, tip number seven is to just say what comes to you and don't edit. Just let things roll out. Oftentimes when we do start to edit it and think, oh no, I can't say that, that's stupid, that's often the message that the reader needed to hear.
Yeah.
So make sure to definitely spit it out.
My tip number eight is to play 20 questions for deeper detail. You know what I'm talking about with this. I teach a lot of psychic development classes, and I always believe that to get really down to the nitty-gritty, to get all of the really juicy, awesome details that you want when you're giving a really awesome, accurate, and detailed psychic reading is you have to dig a little deeper than what's right on the surface. So you will find when you go in to do a reading, maybe you're looking at your cards, like Andrea says, or your crystals for something like I'm doing, or any type of process you're doing, you're going to get a lot of low-hanging fruit information. You're going to kind of get stuff that comes to you right away that maybe is considered to be a little louder than the others. And, you know, if you give all of that information, you just say it, it's great, but you shouldn't stop there. What I like to do is play 20 questions. So let's say we have someone coming in. We feel like it's a grandmother and we feel this kind of feeling like they have a little bit of regret. Okay, great place to start. How about we ask 20 questions? We ask, hey, grandmother, are you from the mother's side or the father's side? And if we ask this question, a lot of times we get an answer. So we'll feel mother's side or father's side. If we say, hey, grandmother, do you have regret about how you treated them in life? And we'll get an answer, yes or no. Do you regret the way you passed and maybe you didn't get to talk to them? Yes or no, right? So we can ask whatever we find to be our personal questions that we have that might flavor the details of the circumstance. And by doing that, automatically in our mind, we're going to be gathering more specific details about what it is that we're getting. We're not letting people just ask us all the questions. We're going that step further. We are asking the questions when we do a reading and when we're looking at something. And then we're taking note of our psychic impressions as we dig deeper. Then whatever we do come up with, we tell our readee, and all by golly, they say, I can't believe you got that much detail, when all we had to do is kind of ask the question in our mind. So that is my number eight tip. 20 questions for deeper detail, and then speak up and say them, just like Andrea said in tip number seven. So tip number nine, Andrea, go ahead.
I always like to pull a final thought. So I'll pull one more card or see if I can get any more sensations that will either confirm or validate anything that I had mentioned earlier. And if there's any points that the angels are interested in driving home, that's something that I like to do right before I kind of close up.
Perfect. My tip number 10 is practice and calibration. Please do not let your few readings stop there, especially if you're dedicated to doing readings full time or maybe even going into doing readings professionally. Practice and calibration is important. Now, we know what practice is. Keep doing, right? And then calibration is really the process of asking yourself when it was done, how accountable am I to the information that came through, the accuracy that came through, and find out what works by speaking up, sharing what it is that you are getting, and asking yourself whether that was a process that seemed to produce accurate results or not. You can keep doing what works and kind of get rid of what doesn't work, and you will be practicing and calibrating your craft. Now, tip number 11, Andrea.
I think it's always important to practice gratitude and to say thank you for the connections that were made and for the information that you receive, because it helps reaffirm the fact that you are in a mutual working relationship with spirit and not just yourself.
Perfect. And tip number 12 to round it out is, don't forget, ongoing psychic development. Between classes and books and resources and meditations that'll help you open up your third eye or any of your tools that you use in your psychic readings, this is also very, very important. Now, if our listeners would like to receive some psychic development tools from you, Andrea, where do they go?
Right now they can go to facebook.com/angels2fly444 and you'll find my page there along with a list of meetups and events that I'll be doing.
Fantastic. And if you'd like to do any ongoing psychic development classes with me, Tana Newberry, you can reach me at www.crystalsbytana.com. I hope you had fun, Andrea.
I hope you had fun too, Tana.
It's always fun. And we hope you had fun with our 12 tips for developing your psychic readings, making them more accurate and more resonating. We want to say to you blessings and namaste.
Bye.